Hello, everybody. Happy New Year. Happy 2022. Day two. All right. Hope everybody enjoyed their holidays. Everybody is safe and sound, healthy and strong, and ready to rock and roll. All right. You see it on the board back there. Day two. It's been a while since I've done anything. What did you think? I was on vacation? Nope. I've been here planning and thinking, okay, what is it that we need to get done in this new year? Some of you have already subscribed to the courses that are out here, which is great, but we're going to talk about that in a second, right? In a little bit, all right? One of the things that I like to share with you that I did this year, you know how the saying, out with the old, in with the new? Well, we went into a garage. Went into a garage. And we clean house. Man, did I find a treasure trove, however you say it, or stuff. I found computer kits from way back in 2000, the soldering thing. I found networking kits. I found my crimper, found my wire strippers, all this stuff. Okay, it was pretty cool. Books, networking books, poetry books. And this was a joy to find. This was a booklet, right? A booklet written by my 9-year-old then stepdaughter, which she's now 32. And it was a Mother's Day card. Look at it. Look at it right here. It was a Mother's Day card. You see that? Mother's Day. Who's the author, right? Stephanie. And then she is also the illustrator. She says it down here. And you should see the things that she writes. I'm just going to read you a little bit. If you don't mind, it's really going to take a second. It's not a big deal. It was a beautiful day until school started. And that's it. That's all she wrote. But she left some blank pages. She left some blank pages in between. So I have I'm assuming that she's, you know, letting the reader finish the rest. It's like, okay, it was a beautiful day until I started school, and then you can take it from there. Or she basically said, it was a beautiful day, now I gotta go to school, and the day sucks. But basically, this is the mindset of a 9-year-old, of a 9-year-old child, all right? There, you know, it's a happy Mother's Day thing. That's cute. That's awesome. You know, she loves her mom. She's making a Mother's Day card. That's great. But that's a 9-year-old. The 9-year-olds can get too complex. Could you imagine a 4-year-old or a 3-year-old or a 6-year-old? I mean, I came to this country when I was 6. I didn't know nothing, okay? So that was her. I just found it hilarious that she took all this time. Because look at it. She stapled it. She stapled it, she folded it, stapled it, colored it, the whole 9 yards, and that's all she wrote. But she's 9 years old. What can we expect out of a young child like that? I think that was a beautiful gesture, but we need to understand that it was a child, just a child. All right, just wanted to share that story with you. Because we did find, a whole bunch of stuff, and I got so excited. I've told you that I worked everywhere. We found my tax returns, okay, from when I was 16 years old working at Burger King, getting paid $3.10 an hour. I made in 1 year a little over $5,000, okay, a little over $5,000. But I was a teenager. I was living at home. I didn't have to pay for anything, right? But that was my tax return, $3.10 an hour. I was working 40 hours a week. Believe me, at Burger King, yeah, I worked throughout my high school. High school back then was 10th, 11th, and 12th. Now that's ninth grade stuff, 10th, 11th, and 12th. And I made $5,000 in 1 year. But what do I got to spend money on? Nothing. I didn't have a car. I didn't have anything. What, I had a bicycle, all right, that I bought from a buddy of mine for 80 bucks. And if I wanted to go out on a date back then, 20 bucks will get you dinner and a movie. Even you can buy stuff at the movie theater. Now you're out of gas. But back then, yeah, man, it was hilarious. It was just a walk through memory lane, right? Because it was like looking at all this old stuff, pictures, all that, it was great. But in all seriousness, when I started looking at all the networking equipment, the books that I've had, I didn't throw away. I threw away some stuff. I threw away some A-plus books from way back in the day. Or I didn't throw them away. I donated them, right? Because I just don't, yeah. That doesn't even mean anything anymore. But it was just great. It was really is. And that's what we did. That's what we did. It was funny. It was funny. It was hilarious. And it was great looking at all these different books. But serious note. We need to make every day count, as I said in the description. This is day two. Okay. It doesn't matter. What did you do today? What did you do yesterday? Are you getting over a hangover? Did you go to work yesterday? All right. What are your goals in 2022? Well, if you're starting out from scratch, Network Plus, Security Plus, CCNA, CCMP. Some people are looking at cybersecurity. That's great. That's awesome. Some people are looking at cloud certifications. That's great. Beautiful. Okay. That's the way to go. You set yourself a goal. But regardless, if you're going into cloud, if you're going into DevNet, if you're going into security, you need to have a basic networking foundation. I'm telling you right now, I've been all last year. It's amazing. All of us that survived 2021, we made it through. We made it through 2021 with all its hurdles. Now, 2022, I, Lazaro J. Diaz, I am saying that this year is the year of change. This year, things will be positive because we will make it positive. We have to. We have no choice. Les Brown, there's a quote that he says that I hope I don't misquote him. Okay. If you don't act on life, life will act on you. Meaning, if you think that you're just praying and hoping for something to happen, it's not going to happen. You need to make it happen. How do you make it happen? Set up a schedule, set up little steps, all right? So you can get to where you need to go. Let me show you this real quick before I continue my little lecture here, all right? This is globed.net. If you can't see that, I'm going to put it on here, okay? It says, all in caps, make it in 2022, okay? And let me go back to my 20-year-old face, okay? That right there on your screen, make it in 2022, is a coupon code for globed.net. 30% off site-wide. What does that mean? Everything on the site is 30% off. All the self-paced courses, all the live online, everything you see in there in globed.net is 30% off. 30% off. I'm going to leave it here for a while so you guys can see that. Okay. The CCMP starts January 8th. I'm looking at my calendar right up there. I have to go like this so I can see far. My CCMP starts January 8th. That's from 6 to 10. Okay. Volume 1, CCNA Volume 1 starts the same day, but that's in the morning. Like I've told you. Okay. I am scheduled all the way up to June. Okay. Please save this live. I missed the beginning. I just started, my friend, but it will be on you. It will be on the Networking Doctors channel, so it'll be there. So don't worry. I just got started. Okay, I'm leaving that coupon code, which is the most important thing, so you can get 30% off on globed.net. Just gonna be there for a couple days, so take advantage of it now. The CCMP is already scheduled to start on the 8th. All right, students already been signing up for the CCMP. You got the CCNA Volume 1. Volume 1 is in the morning. These are weekend classes, weekend courses, live online. So you have the CCNA Volume 1 that starts on Saturday 11 to 3, I believe. And then you can take a look at it, just go there. And then the CCMP is from 6 to 10, I believe. Okay? So everything starts on the 8th, but you need to be getting ready every single day. You need to come to the class ready with questions, the curiosities towards the certification, towards what we're doing. Mike, happy New Year's, my friend. I hope everything is well with you. Life is what happens to you while you're busy making other plans. John Lennon. That is true. That is true. Okay. Definitely, you need to make sure. You need to make sure that you're taking action. This is the year. That's it. That's it. Listen, I keep saying that. I thought last year I got scammed. I got bamboozled in 2021. I thought that it was going to be, that was going to be the year, right? Yeah, no, that wasn't the year. Okay. No, it wasn't at all the year. Okay. But after going through 2021, the world has suffered, has bled. Okay. We have gone through hell and back. We made it. We made it through. We're in the new year. This is the year of change. This is the year where you make it happen. Okay? I know that I have been preparing myself for this year since last year, way since last year. Okay? Heck, even today, when I went to the gym this morning, I did a new leg workout. I thought I was going to die. All right? But I made it through. I barely could walk out of the gym, but I made it through. One of my goals, many goals this year, besides my own certifications, my own education, is, you know, I want my legs to be humongous. I'm not saying I got skinny legs, but I want it to be at least twice or three times the size. Listen, the reality is that hopefully by the end of the year, lats won't fit on the screen. I'll be this wide, okay? And that's just my goal. Will I reach it? I don't know. But I'm going to take the steps to do so. And that's what you need to do. You need to aim high this year. Whether it's your PhD, I don't know, or whatever. If it's your PhD, if it's your CCIE, if it's your whatever. What you want to learn programming. Whatever it is, you set your goals. Set steps that you know you can hold yourself accountable to. Because one of the reasons, and this is, I just didn't come up with it. Oh, boom, a light bulb rang in my head. No, this is from listening to Jordan Peterson. This is from listening to Les Brown, Anthony Robbins, all these people, okay? All these motivational speakers, I get this, okay? We don't like to fail. We hate to admit that we failed. But you set yourself up for failure. You aim high and you just want to go from the ground to the moon in one shot. That doesn't happen that way. It doesn't happen that way. Okay? You got to take it step by step. I don't know if any of you are old enough to remember the Three Stooges from back in the day. They would turn around. They would say inch by inch, step by step, slowly. You know, they had this thing that they're about to hit, you know, knock some guy in the head or something. But the whole point is that everything that you want to do, you got to do it a little bit at a time. A little bit at a time, a little bit at a time, a little bit at a time. Think about it. You have 365 days. One day is gone. Now you have 364 days. It's just another day. It's just another evolution, okay? Do not think of it, well, I still got the rest of the year. I got a couple months. No, you do not. Last year went in a blink of an eye. You need to make sure that you get your shirts. Now, I've gotten not bad things, that, you know, that, but people are saying, no, I don't need my certifications. Okay? I don't need my certifications. I don't need that at all because I've seen CCIEs and all this stuff that and CCNAs and PhDs that when they come to the networking field, they get lost in sales. Sales. And I think I said this in my last live with you guys. Okay? What? First of all, in this new world that we live in right now, this new social world that we live in, okay, certifications are key for engineering. Let me make that straight. For people who want to actually work in the field of engineering, that want to know, hey, how does a protocol work in layer 2 and layer 3? Okay, you need to know this. All right, you need to know this. And if you think I'm wrong, I am willing to have a one-on-one with you or put you live with me on YouTube and we can have a chit-chat. Right there in that ticker in the bottom, one of the latest sites that I'm in, I've been in there for a while, I think I told you, is TikTok. Success with Last. I think I spelled it with two C's and two S's, whatever. at Success with Laz on TikTok. Okay. So go ahead and follow me there so I can get to 1,000 followers and I can go live there. But I can go live there, or we'll go live on YouTube and we'll have a debate or discussion back and forth as to why certifications in the IT profession, as far as being doing the work or even teaching, especially teaching, okay? Especially teaching. You need to be certified. You need to understand the concepts of what you're doing. And that's how I do my classes. So those of you that are already enrolled in the CCNA, the CCMP, the Security Plus, the Network Plus, get ready. Be ready. All right? Because remember, I've been going through the NRC. Almost there. Almost there. It hasn't been a cruise. Believe me, it hasn't been a pleasure cruise. But it's there's a lot of things that they assume in the NRC that they don't teach in the books. So it's up to an educator, you want to put a title on it, an educator to understand and grasp the concept of what they're trying to teach you that they never taught you before or you're trying to figure out. So I have to create the lab, if I am an educator that gives a damn, okay, is create the lab, make you understand what needs to happen or what's going to happen, and this is what you need to know and why you're doing it, all right? Is the who, what, when, where, why, and how, okay? Is it like a journalist needs to know. So as an educator, it is your responsibility or my responsibility as an educator to make sure that I give you the information, the why are you doing this, okay? And the how. But it's your responsibility to absorb this information. So that means taking notes, looking over the recordings that will be made available, okay? Doing your labs, answering questions, participating in the live online courses, not just sitting there, okay? Now I understand some people, because I teach around the world. Some people are in England, some people are in India, some people are in friggin' Greenland, okay? Norway, so they may be taking a course at 1 a.m, everybody's sleeping. I can understand that. Hey, Laz, I can't talk, man. Everybody's sleeping. Cool. I got that. All right. But if not, then you need to be participating. You need to be asking questions. You need to be actively involved in your learning. It's not going to be, it's like an episode of Saturday Night Live when Saturday Night Live was Saturday Night Live with John Belushi and all those people. Okay. Back in the day. Where they open up their mouths. It was the family, right? The kids open up their mouths and the parents came and they chewed the food for them and they put it in their mouth. Yes, they did that. All right? Meaning, I'm not going to spoon feed things to you. I will break it down to you and I will repeat it as many times as I need to, all right, to make sure that you get it. But that's why I am a proponent of doing labs. If you don't lab, you're not going to learn. Muskegee TV at my Mike Merritt. I've been going through a lot of life lately. Okay. All right. No, that's not for me. Okay. Well, I hope you're better. I hope you're doing better, Muskegee. But yes, well, to speak to that, everybody's going through a lot of things. Everybody's going through a lot of things. And that is no joke. The world has suffered in 2021, but we cannot let it bring us down. We need to say, you know what? I need to breathe in deep. I need to suck it up. I need to do whatever it takes. Work 3 jobs. Do whatever you need to do to make sure that you move forward. You can never move back. You need to move forward. No matter how, listen, whoever told you life was going to be easy, lied. Life ain't easy. Life is hard. Hard as hell. And the more it grinds you, it's going to grind you into the life. That was in reference to John. Oh, no problems. Thank you, Ms. Kiki. All right. No matter what life does to you, you got to keep moving around and moving around and moving around and just, you know, weaving and bobbing. You got to move, because you need these certs. I'm telling you, because I get a lot of emails through a lot of different platforms. Okay. I get a lot of emails. People want their certs. They really do. And I know, you know, it's financially whatever. And I try my best. Now you got 30% off. Join. What is it you need? Now, with that said, I said you take it a step at a time, right? Is it, to me, I find it on this, it's a double-edged sword. It's good and it's bad. All right. It's bad because if you're new to networking, oh, no problems, brother. No problem. Angel, no problem, brother. Step by step, right? Now, it's a good thing. Well, it's a bad thing. Let's start with the bad news first. It's bad if you're new to networking and you see, oh, wait a minute. I don't need to take the CCNA. Hell, I don't need to take the Network Plus. I don't need to take the CCNA. And in the CCNP, if I want to, I can go straight to the NRC and work backwards. If you've never been in networking and you follow that, you are throwing your money. Might as well just take the amount of money you paid and burn it, because that's what you're doing. If you can get into networking, I told you, look behind me. On one side, you see the tall books? That's how it used to be. You see the little smaller thing of books? That's how it is now. So they're not giving you the exact same information that they did last time. Don't think that you took the CCNA 200-120 several years ago, and then you're going to come in and take the CCNA 200-301 and pass like that. It's not going to happen. Terminology changes. They're talking about programming languages now. So it's different things. So you need to take the Network Plus. You need to take the Network Plus. From there, you take CCNA, the CCNA. You have to take the volume one and then volume two. Once you get that to that point, you need to make a decision. All right, with the CCNA, you have pretty good understanding of networking. All right, if you did things correctly, you did things the right way, then yes. Okay, you can then make a decision. Am I going to go to Microsoft? Well, you should have some Microsoft either way, but let's say you want to just go full-blown Microsoft, sysadmin, whatever. Or you want to go to DevNet, you want to go to the cloud, or you're going to go to security, whatever it is that you're going to do. At that point, you can make that decision. But if you're going to go move forward into routing and switching, which is what I love, okay, then you need to go take your CCNP and then your full-blown CCNP. Not just the core, you need to take one of the designations. NRC is one of the designations for routing and switching. All right, there's for service provider, there's for a whole bunch of things. SD-WAN, there's a whole bunch of different things. So it's up to you what you want to do. But you need to follow those steps. Now, I know there's people here say, well, last man, I've been in the field for 15 years, 20 years, 5 years. Man, I got this. Really? What do you do at your job? Do you work with routing protocols every day, access lists, VLANs? Are you doing span and leaf? You know, it's called the CLOS. Because from 2017, I found a book, a PDF, because I have tons of PDFs. All right, from 2017 and then 2019. From 2017 to 2019, the CLOS network changed from layer 2, layer 3 to just layer 3. So if you've been doing this for 10, 15 years, have you updated, upgraded? Do you get your hands dirty? I asked a question on TikTok the other day. I don't know when it was. It was on somebody's live that I joined. What knowledge they had on ISIS. And I don't blame the person. I'm not trying to make fun of the person whatsoever. Not everybody knows ISIS. It was a top. I'm the one that started teaching this. Okay? Last year. All right. So they didn't. They knew about it, but they didn't know much information. They said, well, we don't really need to work with it. So that tells me, because I've had students in my class last year, my live online classes, that they work with ISIS. Because ISIS is a major protocol for large enterprise networks, especially data centers and ISPs. And now in your CCNA, ISIS, they just threw it out there. I've been saying this all year long last year. They just threw it out there. And that's why I decided, let me go ahead in March of last year, I believe, March, I believe I put out the ISIS course. Okay. The ISIS master course. This is a product. Listen, if you guys took your certification in 2020, 2023 is over. If you took it in 2021, because you wanted to take it before the change, if you took your 200-this one, the 301, you took, let's say, in February, okay, or you took it in March, that's 2021. 2023, you got a year, it expires. You have to take it again. And I guarantee you, they're gonna change things in there. So you need to make a decision right now, today, okay? You should have made it last year, but that's okay. That's okay. I know the holidays are here. People are gonna be all about Christmas, Thanksgiving, New Year's, all that good stuff. That's why I waited till today. Day two of the new year. Okay? What have you done? You need to make every day count. So you need to take steps. So people are confused. People are literally confused in what certification they need to get and if certifications are good. There's people out there, and I'm telling you this because they did it to me. They did it to me. Nah, you don't need this. Nah, you don't do that. Nah, you can't do this. Nah, you can't do that. And these are family and friends and coworkers. Nah, don't worry about that, blah, 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 blah. Go to college. Now, I'm not knocking college down. You want to go to college? Great. You want to get an associate's in arts, a bachelor in arts, I don't know, whatever. You want to be a psychiatrist, psychologist, a doctor, a lawyer? I don't. Go. You know what I'm saying? You want to be in IT? I'm saying you don't have to. You don't have to do that. All right? You need to be choosy. You need to be picky. Meticulous in your research and see who you're going to get as an instructor, because not everybody goes live like I do. I come here, I say a couple jokes every once in a while, try to be funny, whatever, but I tell you like it is, okay? And I've been on all these friggin' sites, okay? And I see people, some have great resumes. It's just that companies put requirements that are just unrealistic. But they do it on purpose. They put it to scare you, all right? But still, you need your certs. Now, what certs, right? Let's say you're starting out. You know, say, Laz, man, I don't need it, Laz. I've been in the field. I've been in the field for 10 years, 15 years, 20 years. I don't need a certification. I'm good. Yeah, Mr. Diaz, yes. Well, you're in an upper management position or a management position, but we need all our IT. To get certified. So you've been working for a company for 5 years, 10 years, not certified. You got in because you had the knowledge, you had, you know, the capacity to learn and the ability to do what you have to do, the will, desire, all that good stuff, right? But now the company says, you need to get certified. And you're like, oh, this is a cakewalk, man. I've been doing this for 10, 15, 20 years. And you get stuck on the first question because certifications are not the same thing as making things work in the real world like you should. There are concepts and standards that you need to understand. All right? For you to be able to pass a certification. But the company needs for you to have that piece of paper. You need to. All right? Now, I am not only going to teach you the concepts and the whys, but you're going to have all the tools required, all the ammunition in your arsenal so you can pass your certification. And I say that cautiously because it all ends up with you. Because I can give you a boatload of information. I can drill you till you're blue in the face. But if you don't do your work, if you don't put in your effort, it's not going to happen. That's why I'm telling you, do not set up a schedule that you cannot hold yourself accountable to. So you set up a schedule. Okay, I'm going to take Laz's CCNA Volume 1. I'm going to start there. Even though I've been networking for 15 years, let me see what they've done. Oh, wow, they did new terminology. Yeah, because when you see that terminology in your test, you'll be like, what the hell? All right. So there's things, there are topics that are taught there. You're going to be asked questions on that maybe you never touched. And now with this new SD-WAN, right, with this Lisp protocol, which is not new, by the way. Those of you that are programmers should know about Lisp. All right. Because it exists. All right. Because I am taking a programming free course. Okay. Because I am. That's one of my many goals this year, but I take it a step at a time. I start from ground zero and work my way up, okay? And I get the books, I get the PDFs, I read and I read and I read. If I have to read the same page 10 times, I'll do it. All right. And I lab it. And I lab it. And if Python is free, download it. Look, I got it right here. Right here. Let me put it in the screen so you guys can see it. There's my Python page right there. I downloaded it. Okay. So just so you know, I'm not playing around. Okay. So this is the year that Laz will work his way into programming. I'm going to be the Python person this year. Oh, yeah. Okay. But I set that goal. So every day I'll do something. I work on the NRC. I work on my book. Today I decided I was going to go live. I haven't talked to you guys in a while. All right. So I wanted to go live today. Okay. To make sure that everybody's up to speed and everybody's doing what they're supposed to do. But please just set your schedule. You know that you need certification. There's certain things, you know, we go to high school, get a diploma, go to college, get a degree. You know, we take steps. So high school, associates, bachelor's, master's, PhD, all that good stuff, right? Well, you need your network plus, you need your security plus, Linux is something that's very prominent. Linux plus, right? CML2, this is Linux. Linux plus, okay? You can take the server plus, then you switch gears. All right, let me take the CCNA. All right, then from the CCNA, let me take the CCNP. Okay, last set, I can start with the CCNA. I got my CCNA. Where do I want to go from here? Do I want to keep going, routing and switching? Do I want to go to Microsoft? Because they got like 120 different certifications now. So what is it that I want in Microsoft? You should have at least an Active Directory certification for Microsoft. So you understand Active Directory. Okay. And, you know, it's just not Active Directory. More things within Active Directory that you can work with. But you can say, hey, my thing is cloud. So then you go to AWS, whatever it is that you're going to do. Or, you know, go to cloud infrastructure. Learn to be a cloud expert. Cybersecurity. And, you know, now that I want to get deep into security, because Security Plus, I mean, Never Plus does a very good job right now. That has a lot of security stuff in there. Security Plus, whoop, yeah, deep down and dirty, okay? Well, obviously, if you take an ethical hacking course, you take a cybersecurity course, you take, you know, CISSP, you know, these are different, and there's all the different ones that are insane. I'm taking Sec Plus on Monday, February 14, 2022. Awesome. February 14th? I don't even know. You're taking your certification on February 14th. That's a Sunday. Okay. Well, good luck. Good luck. Good luck to you, Angel. I wish you all the best, brother. I'm sure you're prepping for that. So you get that Security Plus, then he's going to get a letter from the DOD. Okay. That's awesome. That's going to boost your resume up big time. All right. So, but those are your foundational exams. But again, the topic of security, this has come up on every social platform that's out there. Okay. And I mean, they're talking about it on the news, on all sorts of cable networks, everything. Give me a second. They're talking about it everywhere. I've always said it. There's no such thing as security. No such thing. Nope. I don't care if you're, and I don't care who the hell you are. The government, an enterprise network. There's no such thing as a 100% secure network. It doesn't exist. It's how determined is that hacker to get to your network? Hey, that wasn't me. Sorry, that was mine. All right. It's how determined that hacker it is to get to your network. Okay. So that's why security is based on layers. There was a hacker that was interviewed in one of these news outlets, okay, that said, all your information is out there. Trillions and trillions and trillions of data that's out there on you. Why? This right here, what we're doing right now. It's out there. Somebody's recording this. What's up? Okay. And they're saving that information for God knows what. Okay. Just because you're in a VPN, I'm secured. I'm in a VPN. No. I'm secured. I have a firewall. No. I'm secured because I don't know why I'm secure, okay? Because you got to set up all sorts of things. Well, you're doing DMVPNs, you're doing honeypots, the DMZ or honeynets. You have all these firewalls with IPSs and IDSs. You have group policies. You have certificate of authorities running, certificates running. You have all these different VLANs, and you're doing policies on these VLANs. You're doing all these things to make sure that somebody doesn't go in. But you know who's going to actually hack you? The person you have working for you. The disgruntled employee. The person that's just never happy. It's unfortunate, but those people exist. Okay? They weasel their way in somehow into your company because they're a nice person. Hey, man, Lash has a nice goatee, man. The insider. Exactly. Thank you, Angel. Okay? Lash has a nice goatee. I mean, he's got a bald head and all, but, you know, it's kind of shiny sometimes, so I kind of like the guy. You know what I mean? Let's go ahead and give Lash a chance, you know? He wrote a book. He seems like he knows what he's doing. We can probably go out with him, you know, have a couple of beers, you know, bowl, play some pool. He's cool. Then Lash gets in there, plays around for the first 90 days, plays his role, and at the 90-day mark, where you're a permanent employee, that's the way it used to be in my time, all right? Then at that mark, I know they can't fire me, so I'm in there, and then I'm going to start doing things that I know I shouldn't be doing. That's how ransomware works, okay? And people leave these doors open, okay? Back doors. Oh, well, we didn't have any password on our servers. Why? You're an MST. Why don't you have a password on your server? So if you're going for your cybersecurity, you're going for your, you know, like Angel, he's going to do his Security Plus, which is awesome. I'm logging it. That's good. Take it to heart. Take that Security Plus to heart, my man. All right? That's the beginning. That's the beginning, okay? Take that to heart, and then revamp that thing, all right? So you take that to heart, and I'm teaching that starting when? February 11th, actually, January, I'm sorry. January 11th, I'm teaching Security Plus, the new one, okay? And that goes all the way up to March 10th. If they fire you, do not set up a logic bomb. So they can rehire you. Listen, I know of a person. Jan 11th, I'm taking it. I'm starting that course. Jan 11th, Security Plus. I know of a person who did do that. Well, he really didn't do that. He actually left a door open where then he just shut that network down. But they didn't pay him. And then he shut the network down. But I don't know, that's what I'm trying to say. We have all these, not only certifications from CompTIA, from Cisco, from Microsoft, okay, or specialized vendors, firewalls in particular, or we have degreed people, people with masters in security, PhD in security, cybersecurity. You can go learn in Virginia some FBI school, whatever, of, you know, hacking, and we're still getting ransomware attacks. We're still getting, you know, our business emails compromised. I said it last year. It's 1.8 million. I need to look at the IC3.org. Take a look at that. Go to the IC3.org and see what's going on. So it's just not enough to get your certifications. If you are certified with your foundational, right, your CompTIA stuff, and then you got your Cisco, at least to the CCNA, all right, and you go into security, and you got your cybersecurity, you got your CISSP, you know, all these different things. I hope you did this correctly. You labbed everything out, whether it be an emulator or simulator, whether it be lab equipment, however you did it, you understand the concepts of how you should secure a network, what will be the best design that you need to do in a network so you can put it to work. You can make it, you know, you can take what you've learned and go to a job site and make it happen, okay? It's not enough just to get your cert. There's a lot of people out there that are certified that I wouldn't let them near a switch. I wouldn't let them near a hub or even touch a freaking cable, okay? Because they got certified the wrong way. You need to get your certs the correct way by reading page by page, paragraph by paragraph, sentence by sentence, answering all the questions in the book, answering all the questions. And because you have to register that book online, even the Cybex books, especially the Cisco Press books, You can go online and register them. They got extra videos. They got extra questions. And you labbed it. You labbed it because I can tell you right now, the UNARSI, they show you like a little image of four routers. Oh, this is an external network. This is an external network. We're going to do a not-so-stubby area, a not-so-stubby area. And they have those arrows pointing this way, arrows pointing that way, type 7 LSAs, type 5 LSAs, type 4 LSAs. This is what happens. Cool. Let's go on. What? Wait a minute. What's going on? You need to lab it. You need to lab it in order for you to see it working. If you don't actually do it, you're like, oh, that's when the light bulb turns on. Like, oh, okay. That's what happens. That's what happens. Okay? You need to do this properly, step by step. Your foundational CompTIA stuff, CCN, you know, you get to CCNA, good foundation right there, networking, done correctly. And then you can decide which way you're going to go. Microsoft, cloud, security. But if you're taking these certifications, especially security, which is a very hot topic. Hot topic, major concern in today's global existence in this planet, all right? Security is crucial. So if you're taking these certs or you're in a college already, you decided to take IT by going to college, I don't know why, but okay. Then you can go ahead and after you pay your $200,000, 20 years down the road, you can go ahead and put it into work. Hopefully somebody will hire you quickly so you can go pay that back. And they'll pay you a good salary on top of that, okay? Because I think the average salary, maybe $60,000, you know, if you're lucky, all right? You may get lucky and get to one of these places that will pay you six figures, low six figures, $100,000, $110,000, okay? But that's another thing that's going to change this year. People asked me this question last year. That's what the YouTube channel that you see here there on that ticker, Success with Laz, that YouTube channel, okay? That's where I'm going to be putting all the stuff for content, to be a content creator. Everything is going to be online, okay? If I go to Publix, it's to get friggin' milk or some minor stuff. Everything else is done. My wife orders it through Amazon or through DoorDash or through Uber or through whatever it is. Everything is done online. People are working online. Nobody is working. I mean, in IT, we have that luxury. We're not like a nurse that has to be in the hospital. But even still, I think last year I showed where a doctor was actually stitching up a mannequin. It was like a dummy with pork skin, I think, or something like that. He was on the surface. This thing was like underwater, and through robotics, he was doing surgery, you know, miles away. So this is a reality that we're going to be facing. We're going to go into an operating room, and they may not, everybody may not be there. The doctor's actually working on you. He's working on you from another continent, and he's operating you that way. So you need to learn this. So cloud, yeah. Networking, yeah. Security, could you imagine? Somebody having remote surgery, robotic arms, and a hacker gets in between that, and that's not even funny. I laugh, but it's not even funny. Could you imagine what they can do? This is why IT, you need to get the books, read the books, find the right instructor, the instructor that's going to teach you. I try to make things fun. I do a lot of labs. I try to do as many labs as I can. Some things you just can't lab, okay? Some things you just need to, like the OSI model and the Cisco three-layer model and the TCP/IP four-layer, five-layer model and the understanding the collapse core, collapse architecture. All these, there's certain standards. You're going to have to just grin and bear it. You're going to have to learn that. You need to make sure that you know, you understand what you're doing, okay? But you gotta lab it. Hold on for a second. Please share your all CCNA exam for me. You want me to share all my CCNA exams that I've taken? What? You want me to put my grades or something like that? You want to check my credentials? Just go online, okay? And look for me and see what I know. Okay, see what I know. All right, that, I don't know what you're getting at with that. All right, and again, if you the reason I'm telling you this because in college, if you get a bachelor's in science, awesome, you're a good programmer. You get a bachelor's in, I don't know, what is it, IT? You know, I don't know how many people I've taught. Okay, hey, what's up, Raj? I know, Raj. I know what you're gonna ask, and I have not forgotten. It's been insane. Okay. I haven't been on vacation, my friend. I've been working my butt off, but it's good to see you. I left you, I think, in a certain situation. I hope everything is fine with you and your family. All right. So happy, thank you, sir. Happy New Year to you as well. But I have not forgotten. Okay. What was I going to say? I was saying something. Oh, bachelor's. So if you have a bachelor, I've taught many people that have their bachelor's in IT. From known universities down in South Florida. They didn't know anything. I knew people in that same school that where I ended, which was the technical school, that were IT people. Some were IT people. Some were just people that got their certifications the wrong way. And when they got to me, and day one for me, just so you know, day one, we can skip day one with last. Everybody had that thought. When I was teaching at the colleges and even in the technical school, day one, we can skip day one. We'll just come day two. Not a good idea with me. Because I give tons. Because what I do is give you like a picture of what everything that you're going to learn in that first day. So you have an idea what to expect. And this year, after going through the NRC, it's going to be enjoyable. It's going to be enjoyable, okay? Because I like learning. I love creating. And well, since I can't draw, since I don't know how to build things like model cars and all that stuff, so networking is it, okay? I love the fact when I make things, you know, they can communicate with each other. That is, to me, that is like, I love it, okay? So when the CCNP, I can't wait to generate. Believe me, I've been marking the calendar off. What did I do today? Okay, I did this. Okay, cool. I did this. And that's what I do. Every morning that I come up here, because now, new routine, 4:30 in the morning, I'm up here in my office. I put up what I do yesterday. I have a grading system for myself, which I learned when I went to UM. It's a check plus, check, and a check minus. Check minus is horrible, okay? Check, you did okay. Check plus, you did what you had to do. Okay? So I keep myself accountable on what I did that day. So I write things down. My wife comes in the calendar. Okay? And I write everything down that I've done. So 4:30 in the morning, I come up here. New thing. Last guy I get rid of, he's got a trim. I got a trim. I'm 55. Now I'm really 55. I said I was 55 all year last year, but I really turned 55 December 20th last year. So I'm 55. Going on 56. Towards the end of the year, okay? 55, and brand new work. I gotta trim out, so I come up here, I do a bunch of different planks and side trunks and all these different things, so I can taper off, and then when I go to the gym, after I prepare, because after I do my abs, that takes me about 45 minutes, then I come here, let me see what I gotta prepare for today, boom, 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 maybe watch a little bit of Facebook news, boom, and then get ready to go to the gym with my stepdaughter, stay there today, almost 2 hours, knocking out the legs, which I can barely freaking walk out of the gym. And that's going to be every day from now on. And then coming back home, eating breakfast, doing what I got to do. And then getting up here and let's go ahead. Let's do some more lectures for the university. Let's write at least half a chapter for the book. Let's go online. Let's do this. I need to make sure that when January 8th hits, it's going to be a storm, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be a storm. It's going to be nonstop teaching to all the way till June. You have this right here. Make it in 2020. Can I increase this so you guys can see that? Make it in 2020, 30% off statewide. Look at me. Site-wide. All right, so that means you come in here. Let me go back a little bit. Go to all courses. Okay. The N10AA, April 16th. The CCNA Volume 1. January 8th, 11 to 3. Volume 2, February 26th to April 3rd, 11 to 3. the CCMP, CCIE, January 8th to March 27th. You're going to be with me for a long time. Okay? Security Plus for the 601, the new one, the one that Angel is going to take, January 11th to March 10th. I don't stop, and I have yet to schedule my workshops, but that's going to continue. Okay? So that's why I tell you, go to globeed.net. If you haven't subscribed, subscribe to it. You got to make sure that you see what I'm putting out. And go to TikTok. And I misspelled it. See how I spelled it down there? Let me see when the ticker comes around. Because I looked at it on my phone. I mean, if I can pull it out for you. Just so you can see it. I should have taken like a screenshot of it. So you can see my TikTok. Okay? You see? Can you see that right there? Success with Laz. I just started. Okay? Success with Laz. Go there. Check me out. All right? Start following me. I'm going to be putting things out there too as well. Okay? And it's going to be a more relaxed environment. All right? Even more relaxed than this because it's TikTok. All right? I got anywhere from, 15 seconds to 3 minutes to give you something. I wish I could take your Sec Plus, but I can't wait tomorrow. No, I got you, brother. I got you. Well, you're going to take it in February 14th, aren't you? Aren't you taking your certification in February 14th, Angel? Because mine is the Security Plus. Is that what you said? My Security Plus starts in January 11th. You're taking your certification January 14th. I wish I could take your Sec. So you're good to go. I don't know who you took or how you did it, but definitely you're ready. And that's another thing which I should say. So one of the things that Angel did, he said, okay, well, I'm assuming, and he said, okay, I got to get this test, right? I'm going to set it for February 14th. I've already gone through the test. I've gone through the class. I did all my studying. I'm doing, I'm getting 90% or 95% in everything that I do, or maybe 100%. So I think I'm ready. I'm going to keep studying till the day before. All right. But he backed himself up against the wall, up against a corner, and he scheduled the exam. That's some things that people don't do. Okay. You need to schedule the exam. That is going to hold you accountable big time for you to take your certification. All right. So let's say the CCMP, right? It ends. Let me look at my calendar. The CCMP ends on February. No, it ends on March. March, what's that? 27th. It ends on March 27th. So let's say you schedule it for the first week in May. That gives you April to absorb the recordings, to do more labs. Then you'll be good to go. Okay, then you'll be good to go. Mr. Laz, what book do you recommend for the Security Plus? Okay, I think I got that here. CCNA, Narrow Plus. I don't have it in the other room. Cybex. Go to Amazon, get the Cybex Security Plus. That's the one I'm going to be using from teaching, where I'm going to be teaching from. Okay, it's the Cybex. And I believe it's Todd Lamley. Okay, the Cybex. That's the one I want to use. Filled with information. Okay. And you can register the Cybex books online. So you have additional information online that you can use. Okay. So definitely that's what you want to do. All right. I am here to help. Okay. I am here to help. And I know you want it bad because today is Sunday and you're here with me, which I appreciate 1,000,000%. Okay. If you want it bad and you don't want to break the bank, okay, then I'm your guy. I'm going to teach you. I'm going to educate you. Okay, you're going to know how to get things done. You'll have the recordings. All right, thank you, sir. Oh, you're talking tomorrow. Sorry. All right, so you need the recordings. I try to make it as affordable as possible. I had a huge sale before. What was it? The November where I had the CCMP for $500 or something like that. Okay. Some people took advantage of it. Some people didn't. Okay. Then I had like a 40% sale. Now I got a 30% sale. Okay. I'm trying to help you guys out. I'm going to be doing a lot of throughout the entire year. It's nonstop. A lot of live online classes. You need to get And I want to say this for the last time, because I've already kept you here for almost an hour. You need to get your certifications. That's it. Bottom line. I know this is going to be a good year, but we always have our doubts, don't we? We live in uncertain times. You need to get your certifications. That is your ammunition. We do not have the luxury to go, some of us anyway, I'll say it that way, to go to a four-year college, or maybe if you're getting your master's, another 5 years or 6 years, a PhD, 10 years. If you're getting a master's and a PhD, are you going to be teaching in IT? Is that what you're going to do? Are you going to be teaching? Then you don't need that. You're going to be in debt unless you, I don't know, you go viral somewhere and then you start making money off that. Okay? And that's one of the things I'm going to be doing Success with Laz. This is going to be the year where I'm going to start doing, you know, why you should become a content creator. And I will have a course. Okay? A course that will guide you step by step on everything that I did and how to get it done so you can be successful. That's why Success with Laz. Believe me, if anybody's been through it, I've been through fire. I've been through fire. Okay? So I know. But again, you need to have a backup plan. First of all, your certifications are your ammunition to get through the door in HR. You need your foundation, whether it's your CompTIA, then you get into the Cisco, Microsoft, cloud, security, whatever it is, but you need a foundation in networking. It's not enough for the Network Plus. You need at least a CCNA, minimum. I hear a lot of people talking, because I don't you think I go on YouTube and I look at other people, what they're teaching and how they're teaching and what information is being put out there? I do. I don't say anything. I just listen. This is amazing. You just let people talk and just listen to what they say. And you're like, oh my God. Okay, now I know why. Thank you, Mr. Angel Perez. I appreciate that, brother. Thank you so much. I really, really appreciate that. And I wish you the best, brother. And hopefully one day I can have you with me, man. But thank you very much. I truly appreciate that. And again, listen, you can always reach out to me. If you're getting, I don't know, cold feet before your test, if you have any questions, you can always reach me through Instagram or through my email. But Instagram would be a good way. Hey, now TikTok is another way you can reach me really good. I'm obsessed with TikTok. But anyway, get your certs. It's important, all right? Get them the correct way. Understand what you're doing and put it in practice, okay? Just don't get the cert. Okay, I got the cert. No, put it in practice, all right? This whole year, I'm going to do what I need to do as an educator and as an engineer to make sure that you get the information that you need and you understand what you need. I am here for you. I'm all over the place, okay? So you can reach out to me. You can reach out to me. But go to globed.net now. Check it out. Start planning. Make your schedule. Make it happen. Make each day count in this new year. I want to thank everyone for being here today on this Sunday. Angel, thank you very much. I appreciate that, brother. Thank you so much. I appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. I really do. All right. And for all of you being here on a Sunday, thank you so much. All right. I will be seeing you very often. Okay. So be on the lookout. Because Laz is going to be like I said last year, it's going to be a barrage of Laz all year long. Cool. You guys have a happy Sunday. Take care. I'll see you in the boot camp.